So insulin resistance is a condition that people with type 2 diabetes are often living with, whereby the cells of their body don't readily accept the sugar that the insulin, the hormone insulin, is trying to put into the cells of their body. And if the cell is resistant to accepting that glucose, it's not, that glucose is not going to get the opportunity to go into the cell and be converted into energy. And instead it just sits in the bloodstream. And this is where we see these higher blood sugar levels that sort of just sit there all day long. When we think about how we eat, we'll eat our foods that contain carbohydrate. That carbohydrate gets digested, and the glucose is what we get from that carbohydrate once it's digested. The glucose needs to travel through the bloodstream to the cells of our bodies. So our pancreas makes this really great hormone called insulin. It gets released once it detects that there's this sugar in the blood. And the insulin's like a transportation vehicle. So it sort of comes out, takes up that glucose, and carts it to the cells of the body. When it gets to the cell, it sort of acts as a key, right? And it's like there's a lock on the cell wall. And it helps to get that sugar from the bloodstream and into the cells so it can get converted into energy. People who are living with type 2 diabetes have a bit of trouble with this. You know, they could be experiencing insulin resistance, or sort of like a rusty cell lock. So that lock on the cell isn't sort of allowing that insulin to get the sugar in. They also over time get this sort of progressive decline in the amount of insulin that their pancreas is even putting out. And then the last thing that a lot of them are looking at is leaky liver. So a leaky liver is essentially our liver will put out sugar into the bloodstream at times that we need it. So say if it's detecting that our blood sugars are low, but it also does it, during times that we're fasting or even sleeping overnight. And sometimes that liver will leak out more than we need. It'll put out sugar at times when we don't really need it. So there's a combination of all these different things that could be going on where it leads to this sort of higher blood sugar. So we have to sort of manage that with things like diet, exercise, and possibly medications and or insulin in the long run.